The Cuban Missile Crisis was the closest we came to nuclear catastrophe. In the end, the two sides choose a diplomatic settlement. But what if either Khrushchev or Kennedy had decided to choose war over diplomacy? An American decision to use force would have resulted in many more American as well as Soviet casualties. American plans were to have an airstrike followed by an invasion. The United States thought that the Soviets had between 12,000 and 15,000 troops. In fact, the Soviets had between 40 and 50,000 troops. Their attack against the Soviet bases would have resulted in many more casualties. In addition, the United States didn't know about some of the smaller nuclear weapons that the Soviets had managed to put on the island. And had the United States invaded Cuba, there were 12 short-range missiles on the island placed at the likely landing sites for any U.S. Marine amphibious attack. The Soviets would have felt the need to retaliate somewhere. And the most vulnerable place was the divided city of Berlin. The Soviets would have taken Berlin, then France and Great Britain, as well as the United States, would have found themselves at war with the Soviet Union. And the Cold War would have become a hot war. Had the Cuban Missile Crisis resulted in a war, people like Lee Harvey Oswald, who had been in the Soviet Union, might well have been interned as potential political threats. It is quite possible that Lee Harvey Oswald and John F. Kennedy would not have been in the same place at the same time in 63, in which case John F. Kennedy does not lose his life and has a second term. Well, then what might have happened? Neither country saw it was in their interest to have a nuclear exchange over the divided city of Berlin. The sides would have tried to negotiate out of the situation, but there would have been enormous pressure to do more. And allies of both sides around the world would have taken the fact of an actual violent clash as a signal to push for their own gains. And so you would have seen violence in Southeast Asia, more violence in Latin America, and both sides would have tried very hard to avoid nuclear war. But what one cannot know in advance is how successful either the White House or the Kremlin would have been to prevent unavoidable, unexpected, accidental events that would have spiraled out of control.